Hello, my friends. I'm going to show you how to make patterns for cuffed hem using Pant. I'm Jean and welcome back to Pattern Studio 101. I help fashion students who want to improve their pattern making skills. Visit my website, patternstudio101.com, and download some free resources you need. Okay, so we are going to make cuffed hem. You see cuffed hem sometimes on the short sleeve or pants hem. So today's video, I'll show you what tools you can use to make cuffed hem patterns using pad. Let's begin. I have a short sleeve pattern here and we are going to make a 1-inch width cuff at the hem. It's gonna be like this. So you see from the finish line, 1 inch go up and 1 inch go down. So we have a cuff and then 1 inch seam allowance. To do this using pad, we are going to use the tool pattern line. Before we actually make the cuff, I'll show you the options of this tool. You select pattern line and hold down the control key and select the hemline and click the right side of the hemline. I know we have to add lines to the left side to make the cuff, but I wanna have a guideline first. Anyway, when you click, you will get this dialog box. Value means how far you want to copy the line. We want 1 inch. Number of lines, if you say 3 and OK, then you have 3 lines. 1 inch distance between. Got it? I'm going to undo and click again. So now I want to have only 1 line. And you see distance from side 1, distance from side 2. I'm not sure if you can see the point number pad assigned. Here's number 1, here's number 2. So whatever number you enter here, you're gonna have an extended line, longer or shorter line. Let's say 2 inches for side 1, 1 inch for side 2. Okay, you see the extension. 1 inch longer this side and 2 inch longer this side. Let's undo and click again. Okay, attach to contour. If you choose this option, the copied line will be attached to the contour line. Sub option, keep exterior segment. Whether you choose this or not, it's gonna be the same in this case because we copied the line narrow to wider. Let's click OK. You see, the copied line is extended to the contour line. If you copy the line from the wider to narrower, for example, like this, and you check attach to contour and keep exterior segment, then you have this. The copied line is attached to the contour line and you still have length of leftover. That is for this option. Let's go back to our sleeve. Select the pattern line, click the right side of the hemline. The last option, permanent. Permanent is not going to copy the line, it will move the line. You have sub options, perpendicular and extension. If you choose perpendicular, the hemline moves and is connected 90 degrees. I'm gonna undo and let's choose extension. Click OK. Then you see the hemline moves and is extended to the side seam. That's it. We learned all the options. Let's make a guideline for the cuff hem. Value is 1 inch. Attach to contour. Click OK. Hold down the control key and select the hemline again. And click the left side of the hemline. 1 inch moving and permanent. Click OK. We added 1 inch and this is the actual hemline. and we will fold it, right? So select the tool, align 2 points in X. We are going to align 2 points. Click the point on the guideline we made and click the point we just extended. Let's do the same to the other side. And we want to do this one more time. Select parallel line, click the left side of the hemline, 1 inch, permanent, okay. Again, select align 2 points in X, click the point on the hemline, click the point on the line we just made. The same way to the other side. Let's remove the guideline we made. We don't need it. It's done. And when you add seam allowance, you add 1 inch seam allowance to the hem. Then you can make cuffed hem on the short sleeve. I really love making patterns with pad. Actually, I prefer to have gobber, but it's too expensive for personal use. So I use pad to make patterns and I'm so happy with it. Okay guys, have a wonderful week and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.